Hi Taurus, hope you're well. Welcome to your reading. Today I'm going to pull your money and career energy, your love energy, and I'll see who's coming and going. Now, if you have a certain amount of money you'd like to manifest, or if you have a specific person in mind, you can go ahead and like this video and subscribe. And if you are interested in scheduling your own personal reading with me, all the info you need is in the description box below. Now, for a totally fresh perspective, you can check out my wife's channel over at Empath Tarot. You will love her. And stay tuned until the end of your reading. We'll use oracle cards and I'll pull your affirmation for today and a final message from your spirit guides tying everything together. All right, so let's dive right in. See what we got going on. You got the Eight of Cups and the Four of Cups. Right now, Source is telling you to shine brighter and attract higher. That's it. The more that you're shining, the more that you're genuine, authentic self, the more that you're following excitement, joy, passion, and bliss, the more money you're going to get and the more love that's going to come into your life. Both of those are a byproduct of someone who is happy. Now, being happy is the ultimate goal. I'll give an example. Imagine you are here and you want to get rich. Why do you want to get rich? Because being rich will make you happy. Or imagine you are here, you want to be with your soulmate. Why do you want to be with your soulmate? Because soulmate will make you happy. Now, if you cut out the middleman and tell yourself, I am going to be happy now, because it's all perception. When you are happy, like attracts like, law of attraction, you will get what you're looking for much, much quicker. That's why celebrating the event before it takes place, this is the kicker, right? Being able to use your creativity, imagination, and telling yourself, okay, listen, it's not about what's realistic. That means nothing, right? Placebo effect is definitive proof. It means nothing. You change your metabolism by just with your thoughts. What you want to do is think about, it's about creativity and imagination. So if you want to get that dream house, rather than tell yourself, how would I possibly get that? I'm not in that tax bracket. Don't worry about that. That strategy does not work, right? What you want to do is just focus on, no one can prevent you from visualizing something. No one can do that. It's your birthright. So visualize yourself in that dream house, fresh paint. Visualize yourself celebrating your first wedding there, birthday there, whatever you're looking for, celebrating your first barbecue. When you start doing that, now there's going to be a path, a road, a outcome, a stream of consciousness, centralized intelligence, an infallible guide telling you how to get there through action steps, through being in alignment. But it all starts from your creativity, imagination, and allowing and gifting yourself the choice and opportunity to get where you're going. Now, you have the Eight of Swords and the Ten of Swords, letting you know that there's friction here and that there's an energy block. Now, the energy block is a jam signal from you in spirit, and that happens whenever we're putting too much pressure on ourselves. So, for example, I should have been rich by now. I should have met my soulmate by now. That energy right there is completely unnecessary, and I'll give you an example. Imagine you're in the car. You're trying to get to your objective. Now, imagine you're driving, but you drive back. You're driving, but you drive back. You know, what is this, right? You want to go from here to here and get there. Now, in order to get to here, you got to stop being hard on yourself. Everything happens for a reason. You do not waste any time. If you dated someone that did not work out, it's for you to collect data. What do I like? What do I not like? If you were at a job and you weren't, you know, it wasn't your dream job and you're going to find a new job, it's so you know what you don't want, right? So Source is letting you know that this contrast is necessary. Good thing you experienced it then so you don't have to experience it again. And right now, to look at it from that point of what is happening, why did it happen, what was the lesson, and to be able to move on. And that's exactly how you clear any one of these limiting beliefs. Now, you got Temperance and you have the Page of Cups. So Source is telling you that trust your intuition and instincts because it is the yellow brick road. It is going to get you where you need to go. And to infuse your day with one joyful activity, right? So for example, like when you were younger, what did you like doing? Did you like painting, singing, dancing, drawing? Did you like tea parties? When you're like 5, 6 years old. Now, do one of those things every single day. Like, for example, imagine you like coloring. Buy an adult coloring book. Throughout your day, whether it's after work, whether it's before sleep, whether it's, you know, early in the morning, just color a little bit. When you are lost in your, you know, passion, when you are lost doing something you love, that's when you're not overthinking. When you're not overthinking, you're allowing the universe to give you guidance, right? And that's how those brilliant ideas come of like, oh my goodness, why did I not think of this earlier? This is going to change my life. That's when you get it. But when you're overthinking, it's like basically like a walkie-talkie. You're holding down the button and you're talking, but you have to let go in order for spirit to start talking back. And that's why when you're coloring away, you're letting go. And that's when spirit can actually speak to you. Now, very interesting. You have the Four and Five. You have the Four Pentacles, the Five of Cups. There's a money block here. This money block is created through past experiences. And right now, it's preventing you from shining. And right now, Source is telling you to start your day with a positive affirmation to clear this money block. When you are living with a memory of the past, you are limited to your experiences. So, for example, what are your experiences? You might have a certain amount of experiences that are in your conscious mind, maybe that much. Now, what's in your subconscious mind is this much, okay? It's just unbelievable. You have 60 to 70. 70,000 thought, 60 to 70,000 subconscious thoughts a day. Imagine the data you have collected. So when you are not limiting to yourself to your memory of the past, now the vision of the future is shining bright. And that's why it's so important right now to be focusing your awareness on really being expansive, joyful, blissful, passionate, having fun, doing the things that excite you, putting your best foot forward, wearing your nails the way you want, wearing your hair the way you want, fellas, doing your beard the way you want, dressing the way you want, speaking the way you want, feeling good, right? Positive affirmations, for example. Like, for example, every single day I look in the mirror and I say something like, I am confident, I am positive, I am witty, I am smart, I am patient, I am sexy, I am charming. Whatever the flavor of the day is, whatever I'm planning on doing. If I'm going to a business meeting, I'll tell myself, I am a leader, I am resourceful, I am the best negotiator, right? If I'm going to go out with my wife, I'm going to say, I am patient, I am funny, I am joyful, right? So it really depends on what you're doing that day, but those positive affirmations work. Now, you got the Three of Cups and the King of Cups, and this is about a third party indirectly or directly referring you to someone that Source wants you to team up with and Source wants you to meet right now. And Source is telling you right now that manifestation is the art of alignment. When you're in alignment, this third party will introduce you. So, for example, I met my wife through a third party. A mutual friend invited both of us to a birthday party. If I didn't have that mutual friend, I would have never met the love of my life. That's what's going on here. When you are in alignment, when you're feeling good, you get invited to functions. You get invited to events. That's how you meet people here or there, whether it's business or love. And that's why it's so important to be in that high vibration, right? To be doing the things that make you excited, being lost with passion, being lost with excitement, blissful energy, and then everything else will become effortless rather than efforted. Now, you got the Strength card and Justice, and this is about anything you touch will turn into gold when you are honoring your soul. This is so important, right? When you challenge and replace limiting beliefs by choosing a positive response to a challenging situation, that's when you're honoring your soul. So anything that happens, you have a choice. Either look at it as if it's happening to you or for you. Either it's a curse or a blessing. Either it's your glass is half empty or half full. This is all perception. Whenever something happens, all you got to remember is that there's a lesson in the situation. What is the lesson here? Why did this happen? What are you supposed to learn? When something happens and doesn't go according to plan in my life, I tell myself, what would I do different? And I would never make that same mistake again. This is what it comes down to, right? Fool me once, shame on me. Fool me twice. Oh no, fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. So it's like just not repeating the same cycle is going to free up a lot of limiting beliefs. Now, you got the Page of Pentacles and the Five of Swords. And right now, Source is telling you that do not limit yourself to settling. This is so important. Do not settle to be at a job where you're not being compensated the money that you deserve. Do not settle being in a relationship, for example, that's not romantic. And settling really means watering your garden and watching it grow. A lot of times we tend to think that the grass is always greener on the other side. The grass is always greener where you water it. And by you not settling the first step, that's when you're actually going to be motivated to water the garden. All right, Taurus, now time for your affirmation for today. If you want to quantum entangle with money and love, write your affirmation down in the comment section, become the cause and effect, and let spirit know you are 100% ready. So write your affirmation in the comment section. This is how you attract a high outcome. Your affirmation for today is, I feel abundant and live a rich life right now. So write this down. I feel abundant and live a rich life now. This is letting spirit know that you are ready. You command, assume, expect, invite, and welcome abundance. I feel abundant and live a rich life now. Write that down in the comment section and let spirit know that you are ready. All right, now final message from your spirit guides. Final message is, love is the reason. So each person in your life is there for a reason, and that reason always has something to do with love. What does that mean? Right now, you got to understand that we all have friends, family members. We all have people who are there, and some of them are, you know, everyone's on their own journey, right? So, for example, like I have family members that I love, but, you know, I expect sometimes more from them because I see their potential. But Source is letting you know everyone's in your life for a reason. Like, for example, like maybe I am supposed to be learning how to be more patient or more, you know, open or more inviting when it comes to certain people. And that's what it is. You know, if someone is not really showing you the attention, love that you are expecting, you got to understand that they're going on their own life's journey. Like they're going through their ups and downs. Who knows what they're dealing with, their childhood, their traumas, their relationships, their bills, their worries. And the only thing that really, you know, the only variable that really counts is you, right? So as long as you are feeling good, as long as you're controlling your energy, your reaction, your choices, your behaviors, then everything else will fall into place organically and everything will work out the way it's supposed to. All right, Taurus, hope you enjoyed your reading. Hope there was a message in here for you. If there was, like this video and subscribe. I appreciate you. Till next time, chat soon.